Hello friends, welcome back to the lecture series of electronics component. In this video, we are going to discuss about solid state physics. So let's start with atom. In 1930, the physicist Niels Bohr proposed a model in which the electrons of an atom were assumed to orbit the nucleus, but could only do so in a finite set of orbits, and could jump between those orbits only in discrete change of energy corresponding to absorption or radiation of a photon. An atom is the smallest constituent unit of ordinary matter that formulate a chemical element. Every solid, liquid, gas, and plasma is composed of neutral or ionized atom. Atoms are extremely small, typically size around 100 picometer. So let's start with matter. Matter is anything which has mass and occupies space. It can exist in any of the following three states: gas, liquid, and solid. In gaseous state, the atoms are separated from each other by large distance and are haphazardly arranged. In liquid state, they are somewhat closer but are still arranged haphazardly. In the solid state, atoms are the closest and take an orderly three-dimensional geometric pattern called crystal lattice, as shown in the figure. So, matter can be classified in three different types. First one, that is gas, second one, that is liquid, and third one, that is solid. Solid can be further divided into two types. First one, that is non-crystalline, and second one, that is crystalline. Again, crystalline solid material can be classified into three different types. First one, that is conductor, second one, that is semiconductor, and last one, that is insulator. So let us discuss one by one each and every form of matter. In nature, matter is found in the form of either element or compound. So let's start with element. It is a substance which cannot be broken down any further by chemical method into a simpler substance. For example, copper can neither be decomposed into simpler substances, nor can it be built up from any other substances. Common examples of elements are oxygen, bromine, aluminium, silicon, germanium, and uranium, etc. Elements are identified by such a property as color, density, and melting temperature, etc. They all are made up of identical atoms which consist of electrons, protons, and neutrons, etc. Till today, 106 elements have been discovered. Second one, that is compound. It is a substance which consists of more than one element in chemical combination. For example, hydrogen plus oxygen equal to water, H2O. Second example, sodium plus carbon plus oxygen gives sodium carbonate. The smallest part of a compound which retains its chemical characteristics is called molecule. Now let us discuss the atomic structure which is proposed by Niels Bohr in 1913. An atom is composed of negatively charged electrons moving in fixed circular or elliptical orbits around a heavy positively charged nucleus made up of protons and electrons. The main element in the atom is nucleus. So let's discuss a nucleus. The center core of an atom is called nucleus. It contains protons and neutrons and other subatomic particles. The protons carries a unit positive charge whereas neutrons has no charge, that is, it is electrically neutral. However, it is a heavy as proton and it is about 1840 times heavier than an electron. The two particles are held close together with strong nuclear force. It is believed that whereas protons add both charges and mass to an atom, neutrons adds only mass. Hence, the positive charge of nucleus is due to protons only. The number of electrons in each orbit is fixed. The central force mv square by r necessary to keep electrons rotating around the nucleus is supplied by the force of attraction between their opposite charges as given by Coulomb's law. It is observed that nearer an electron is to the nucleus, greater is the force with which it is bounded to it. The most important parameter in an atomic structure is atomic number. Atomic number is equal to the number of proton or electron contents in an atom. For example, hydrogen atom has one electron in the nucleus. Hence, for hydrogen, Z is equal to 1. For carbon, Z is equal to 6. For copper, Z is equal to 29. For silicon, Z is equal to 14. For germanium, Z is equal to 32. Now next point, that is atomic mass number, which can be denoted by A. Atomic mass number is the total number of protons and neutrons contained in the nucleus of an atom. For example, silicon has 14 protons and 14 neutrons in its nucleus. Hence, its A is equal to 14 proton plus 14 neutron is equal to 28. Similarly, germanium has 32 protons and 41 neutrons. Therefore, A is equal to 73 for germanium. Next one, that is electron orbits or shell. According to Planck quantum theory, an electron cannot revolve around the nucleus in any arbitrary orbit, but it only certain defined discrete and fixed orbit. These orbits are designed by alphabetical letter K, L, M, N, O, P, etc. starting from the nucleus outward. The orbits or shell closest to the nucleus is called K shell. The next further one is called L shell, and so on. Thus, shells are also known by the principal quantum number n, which can have values of n is equal to 1 for K shell, n is equal to 2 for L shell, and so on. The maximum number of electrons a shell can have is equal to 2 raised to n. So, for example, K is equal for K shell, n is equal to 1. That means K shall have 2 electrons. Similarly, L shell with n is equal to 2. So, maximum number of electrons in L shell is equal to 2 multiplied by 2 raised to 2 is equal to 8 electrons. In M shell, n is equal to 3. N is a principal quantum number. So, n is equal to 3. So, maximum number of electrons is equal to 2 into 3 square is equal to 18 electrons in M shell. Similarly, in N shell can have 32 electrons, etc. Each electron orbit is associated with a certain defined amount of energy. While revolving in thus permitted orbit, an electron does not radiate out any energy, but it does radiate out some energy when jumping from one orbit to another. If E2 and E1 are the energies corresponding to the two orbits before and after the jump, the frequency of emitted radiation is given by the relation E2 minus E1 is equal to HF, or delta E, that is the variation in energy between two orbits, is equal to HF, where H is a Planck constant. is equal to 6.625 multiplied by 10⁻¹⁴ joule second. Now, next one topic, that is valence electrons in the orbit. Most of the atoms of different element does not have their outer shell completely filled. That is, they do not have 8 electrons in their outer orbit. The electrons occupying the outermost orbit or shell of an atom are called valence electron. They determine the chemical and electrical property of element. Valence electrons of an element are highly active in sense that they are always ready to chemically combine with other element. Thus, elements which have one or two valence electrons are good conductors of electricity. Thus, valence electrons are responsible for forming an atomic bonds. The number of valence electron in an atom also determine the valency of the element whose atom it is. For example, boron is trivalent, whereas silicon and germanium are tetravalent. That is, they have 4 valence electrons each. Now, next one, that is energy of the orbit. The total energy possessed by an electron when it revolves in the nth orbit of an atom with atomic number Z is given by En is equal to -13.6 Z, that is atomic number, divided by n square, where n is the nth order of the orbit, electron volt. Now let us check some of the important facts of atomic orbit. Total energy of electron is negative, that is, it is a binding energy. Total energy is inversely proportional to the square of the principal quantum number, that is n. Bending energy of electron is less when they revolve in higher order. Total energy of the electron varies as Z square. So this is the introduction video on solid state physics.